Hey all, welcome to Share Trek. This is Raj here, friends. Some of you have been really very helpful and provided me with a list of therapies that you think I should make a video on. And I picked up one of those, which is ABBV-1882. That is ABBV-1882. It's a combination therapy comprising of budigalimab, that is ABBV-181, an anti-PD-1 monoclonal antibody, and ABBV-382, an anti-alpha-4-beta-7 monoclonal antibody. And I'm going to talk about this in this particular video. It took me a little while to read up. There is not much information available in the public domain about how this therapy works, but I've tried to tried my best to understand and present to you what is I think is the mechanism of its operation. And as I learn more, I will come back to you with a more detailed video to explain this even better. With that said, let's get started. Welcome back, friends. ABBV-1882 is a combination therapy comprising of ABBV-181, which happens to be an anti-PD-1 monoclonal antibody, and ABBV-382, which is an anti-alpha-4-beta-7 monoclonal antibody. This regimen is being investigated in phase 2 clinical trials for its potential to control HIV without the need for continuous antiretroviral therapy. The combined action of these two antibodies aims to enhance the immune system's ability to target and control HIV-infected cells more effectively. And friends, in the last video, we had spoken about PD-1 and PD-2, programmed death 1 protein. It's a checkpoint protein found on T cells, including both CD4 plus T cells and CD8 plus T cells. When PD-1 binds to its ligands, which is PD-L1 or PD-L2, it sends an inhibitory signal that reduces T cell activity. This mechanism normally helps prevent autoimmunity, but it can be hijacked by HIV and is hijacked by HIV to evade the immune response. HIV increases PD-1 expression on T cells, leading to T cell exhaustion, a state where T cells are less effective in responding to the virus. Now, budigalimab blocks the interaction between PD-1 and its ligands, lifting the inhibitory signals and potentially restoring the function of exhausted T cells. Reactivated CD8 plus T cells, which are basically cytotoxic T cells, can more effectively identify and kill HIV-infected cells. Reactivated CD4 plus T cells improve overall immune response, supporting CD8 plus T cells and B cells, which produce antibodies. ABBV-382, which is an anti-alpha-4-beta-7 monoclonal antibody, is also added into this mix because it is an integrin protein expressed on the surface of certain T cells, which guides them to migrate towards the gut-associated lymphoid tissues, or GALT. GALT is a significant site for HIV replication and persistence, harboring viral reservoirs that are difficult to eliminate. ABBV-382's role is that by targeting alpha-4, beta-7, ABBV-382 modulates the trafficking and retention of T cells in the gut. This helps reduce the HIV reservoir in the gut, enhancing immune surveillance and clearance of the virus in these critical tissues. The combination of these two therapies provides a synergistic effect that enhances the immune system's ability to control HIV. Budigalimab reactivates exhausted T cells, particularly CD8 plus cytotoxic T cells, enhancing their capacity to target and eliminate HIV-infected cells. And ABBV-382 ensures that reactivated T cells effectively home to and act within the gut, a major site of HIV persistence. And the synergistic effect is that the reactivated T cells that are better localized to the gut create a more comprehensive and effective immune response against HIV. This dual mechanism helps reduce viral reservoirs and sustain viral suppression, potentially allowing for control of HIV without continuous ART. At least that's the way I understand it right now. But if my understanding changes, definitely come back to the channel with another video to explain it. I've also gathered some phase 2 study details because, friends, that's what you're going to ask. What is the stage it has reached? When is phase 2 starting? So here are the details. The purpose of phase 2 study is to assess changes in disease activity, adverse events, tolerability, and the pharmacokinetics, which is how the drug moves through the body. So they're going to do the study for ABBV-1882, which is a combination therapy. Participants will be divided into one of five treatment arms, each receiving a different treatment combination. There is a 1 in 7 chance of being assigned to a placebo group, which will not receive the active drug and is not expected to have any chemical effect on the body. Approximately 140 adult participants with HIV who are on stable antiretroviral therapy and willing to undergo analytical treatment interruption or ATI will be enrolled across approximately 90 sites worldwide. And the participants will receive 4 doses of intravenous budigalimab or placebo combined with 3 doses of IV ABBV-382 or placebo over an 8-week dosing period. On the first day of the first injection, participants will stop their antiretroviral medication, often referred to as ATI or analytical treatment interruption, for up to 52 weeks or until they meet specific criterion to restart ART. Participants will be closely monitored during the ART interruption period and will be followed up to approximately 52 weeks. And the protocol-defined criterion for restarting ART include participants' request and other clinical parameters. Participants will undergo regular visits to the hospital or clinic for medical assessments, blood tests, side effect monitoring, and completing questionnaires. Some follow-up visits may be conducted virtually or through home health visits. And the study aims to determine whether ABBV-1882 can sustain viral suppression without continuous ART, thus reducing the lifelong treatment burden for HIV patients. The treatment has a higher burden compared to standard care due to the frequency and type of visits and monitoring required, but it has the potential to significantly impact HIV treatment strategies. In summary, ABBV-1882 is a combination of budigalimab and ABBV-382, and it aims to enhance the immune response against HIV by reactivating exhausted T cells and improving their localization to gut issues. In summary, ABBV-1882, a combination of budigalimab and ABBV-382, aims to enhance the immune response against HIV by reactivating exhausted T cells and improving their localization to gut tissues. This combination therapy is being evaluated in a phase 2 study involving 140 participants on stable ART. The study assesses the therapy's efficacy, safety, tolerability, and pharmacokinetics while participants undergo a monitored ATI. And the ultimate goal is to achieve long-term viral control without continuous ART, potentially transforming HIV treatment. So there you have it, my friends. This is how I understand it right now. I'm still searching for more detailed information on how the mechanics of this therapy is. As soon as I get more information, if I have said anything wrong out here, I'll come back and correct it. But in general, this is how it works. The next question will be, when will it come to the market? Well, it all depends on how it performs in the clinical trial and what the FDA says. So stay tuned. I'll keep track of this therapy and bring back a video in future for you. With that, my friends, I'd like to bring this video to an end. And as you have seen, our channel is growing fast and we want to go to the next milestone, which is 15,000 subscribers. So if you haven't subscribed, smash the subscribe button, smash the like button, and if possible, send the link of this channel to your friends and ask them to become a subscriber. Thanks and have a great day.